Prabhu, you're on mute.
Please forgive me, Hare Krishna, dear devotees. Please forgive me. We would just like to welcome everyone today for joining us for our regular midweek program. Today we'll be launching a new series entitled The 12 Mahajans. And our guest speaker will be His Grace Adhikarara Prabhu. So just a little background on this new series that we are launching today. The 12 Mahajans are basically great souls, great persons. And these particular Mahajans that we are covering have been covered in the Srimad Bhagavatam. There are 12 predominant ones, and they have been entrusted with the duty of bringing the jivas, the living entities, to the path of devotional service. So the first one is Lord Brahma, and then Narad Muni, and then Lord Shiva, and then the four Kumaras, and then Lord Kapila, and then Swayambhava Muni, Prahlad Maharaj, and then Janaka Maharaj, and then Grandfather Bhishma, and then Bali Maharaj, Sukadev Goswami, and Yamaraj. So those are the 12 that we'll be covering in the series, this our midweek program. And the first personality will be Lord Brahma. We are very excited to have one of our regular speakers speaking on Lord Brahma today, Adhikarara Prabhu. So Adhikarara Prabhu was introduced to Krishna consciousness by Gaur Gopa Prabhu in 1998 at the age of 18 while he was studying at the Grant Medical College at JJ Hospital in Mumbai. He completed his Bhakti Shastri course taught by Chaitanya Charan Prabhu, and he received first and second initiation from His Holiness Radhanath Maharaj. He currently serves as the Congregational Director for ISKCON Atlanta, and he is a medical doctor and has completed his training at Emory University. He serves as a geriatric hospitalist and lives in Atlanta with his wife Radhabhav Mataji and two children, Gopal and Maitali. Adhikarara Prabhu plays a very important role in our community here in ISKCON Atlanta as a leader, as a mentor, and as a guide, and is known for his amazing katas, narrations, and classes filled with sweet, sweet nectar. And they are very, very pleasing to the ears to hear from Prabhu. He is very scholarly and is filled with a lot of wisdom. And we would just like to thank him for being with us today and for giving us his association. So without any further ado, I will hand it over to His Grace Adhikarara Prabhu. Prabhu, are you ready? Again, Hare Krishna.
Thank you very much, dear Navin Prabhu. I'm very grateful to you for giving me this opportunity, and also very grateful to Sadananda Ramchandra Prabhu and Karthik Kripa Prabhu. Three of you together are doing such amazing service, and I see myself simply as your assistant and your servant. So, dear devotees, on behalf of ISKCON Atlanta, New Panihati Dham, we welcome you for this new midweek series where we will be discussing about and glorifying the 12 Mahajans. So, without further ado, let's get started. We will chant our Mangalacharan prayers first. Om Ajnanati Mirandhasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chakshurun Militam Yena Tasmay Shri Gurave Namah Shri Chaitanya Manobhishtam Sthapitam Yena Bhutale Swayam Rupa Kadam Hriyam Dadati Swapadantikam Vandeham Shri Guru Shri Yuta Padakamalam Shri Guru Vaishnavamscha Shri Rupam Sagrajatam Sahagana Raghunathanvitam Tam Sajivam Sadvaitam Savadutam Parijana Sahitam Krishna Chaitanya Devam Shri Radha Krishna Padan Sahagana Lalita Shri Vishakhanvitamscha Nama Om Vishnupadaya Krishna Prashthaya Bhutale Shri Mate Bhakti Vedanta Swamin Itinamine नमस्ते सारस्वते देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेष शून्यवादी पाश्चात्य देशतारिणे वांछा कल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपा सिंधुभ्य एव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः। नमो महावदान्याय कृष्ण प्रेम प्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्ण चैतन्य नाम्ने गौरात्विसे नमः। हे कृष्ण करुणा सिंधो दीनबंधो जगत्पते गोपेश गोपिका कांत राधा कांत नमोस्तुते। तप्त कांचना गौरांगी श्री राधे वृंदावनेश्वरी वृषभानुसुते देवी प्रणमामि हरि प्रिये। जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैता गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौर भक्तवृंद। जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैता गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौर भक्तवृंद। हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्ण। सो डियर डिवोटीज, इन ग्रंथराज श्रीमद् भागवतम इन द सिक्स्थ कैंटो थर्ड चैप्टर श्री यमराज जी ही मेंशंस दैट देर आर 12 महाजन्स। अवर नवीन प्रभु जस्ट इन्यूमरेटेड देम। सो लेट अस गो टू श्रीमद् भागवतम एंड सी हु दीज 12 महाजन्स आर and in what context Shri Yamaraj ji mentions about these 12 Mahajans. Today, the focus of discussion will be the first Mahajan, Lord Brahma. So let me share my screen and we'll go dive into the pages of Srimad Bhagavatam. So I hope, dear devotees, all of you can see my screen. We are in Granthara Srimad Bhagavatam, 6th Canto, Chapter 3, entitled The Instructions of Yamaraj to the Yamadutas. So Yamaraj is speaking to the Yamdutas who have just been chastised and overpowered by the four Vishnudutas. Ajamil came to his death, and on the deathbed he called his son Narayan, and the last words he uttered was Narayan, come here, Narayan, come here. As a result, immediately four Vishnudutas arrived there, because Narayana has four syllables. Four Vishnudutas immediately arrived there. And because Ajamil had performed sinful activities with his body, with his mind, and with his words, three Yamadutas came to punish him. Karmana Manasa Vacha. He had performed sinful activities with his body, mind, and words. So three Yamadutas came to tie him, his subtle body and the soul, with the Yamapash, with the ropes of Yamaraj, and to take him to Yamalok to award him suitable punishment for his sinful activities. So Ajamil is dying. There are three Yamdutas and four Vishnudutas. The Vishnudutas chastise the Yamdutas for trying to capture Ajamil because he had chanted the holy name of Lord Narayan. And they tell the Vishnudutas tell the Yamadutas, immediately go away from here, otherwise you will be finished. So the Yamdutas go running to Lord Yamaraj. Yamaraj is like the Supreme Court judge. Like in our country, we have the executive branch, which is the president. We have the legislative branch consisting of the senators and others. And then we have the judicial branch, where we have the judge. In this Brahmanda, in the universal management system, Yamaraj is the Supreme Court judge. He is the supreme judge in this universe. And his agents, the Yamadutas, had been overruled. Yamraj directly had instructed those four Yamadutas, go and get Ajamil to me so I can award punishment to him. And Yamraj's order had been overruled and the Yamdutas had been overpowered. So they come running to Yamraj and they ask him, how many controllers are there? We thought you are the supreme judge in this universe, in this Brahmanda. But your orders have been violated. Your orders have been overruled. Please tell us how this is possible. Four beautiful effulgent personalities, they came and they overpowered us. Please tell us the mystery. So now Yamraji is speaking to the Yamdutas in response to that question. Text number 19 of the third chapter of the sixth canto of Srimad Bhagavatam. Sri Yamraji is saying, very important verse, our founder Acharya, His Divine Grace, Abhay Charan Aravinda Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj Srila Prabhupada Ji used to quote this verse many times. Those of us who love to listen to Srila Prabhupada's lectures, we know that this verse, so many times Srila Prabhupada quotes. So let's read verse number 19. Dharmam tu sakshad bhagavat pranitam navay vidur reshayona pideva na siddha mukhya asura manushya kutonu vidyadharacha ranadyaha. Translation by Srila Prabhupada. Because we have much ground to cover in around 50-55 minutes, we will not be able to read the purports. But Srila Prabhupada's purports are very beautiful and very instructive, and we should all read them. So we'll just read the translation today. Real religious principles are enacted by the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Although, so this is Dharmam tu Sakshat Bhagavat Pranita. Bhagwan is actually teaching and enacting the real religious principles. Real religious principles are enacted by the Supreme Personality of God. Although fully situated in the mode of goodness, even the great rishis who occupy the topmost planets cannot ascertain the real religious principles. Nor can the demigods or the leaders of Siddhalok, who say nothing of the asuras, ordinary human beings, vidyadhars and charanas. So Yamraj is telling Yamdutas that only Krishna knows the real religious principles. Because Krishna decides the real religious principles. Krishna manifests the real religious principles. And the rishis, the devatas, the asuras, the siddhas, the vidyadharas, charanas, myself, we don't know. Unless Krishna reveals, we don't know. Text number 20 and 21. These are the verses where the 12 Mahajans are being mentioned. So all these people don't know, but by Krishna's mercy, Yamraj is saying there are 12 people, 12 personalities. By Krishna's mercy, they know what are the real dharma, what is the real religious principles. Swayambhur Narada Shambhu Kumara Kapilo Manu Prahalado Janako Bhishmo Balir Vaya Sakir Vayam Dvadashaite Vijanimo Dharmam Bhagavatam Bhataha Guyam Vishuddham Durbodham Yamnyatvam Ritamashnute. Translation by Srila Prabhupada. Lord Brahma, Bhagavan Narad, Lord Shiva, the four Kumaras who are counted as one here, Lord Kapila, the son of Devahuti Mata, Swayambhuva Manu, who is the first Manu, Prahalad Maharaj, Janaka Maharaj, Grandfather Bhishma Dev, Bali Maharaj, Shukadev Goswami, and I, myself, Yamraj, know the real religious principles. My dear servants, Yamadutas, this transcendental religious principle, which is known as Bhagavat Dharma, or surrender unto the Supreme Lord and love for the Supreme Lord, is uncontaminated by the material modes of nature. It is very confidential and difficult for ordinary human beings to understand. But if by chance one fortunately understands it, he is immediately liberated. And thus he returns home back to Godhead. So in short, real dharma is known by these 12 Mahajans. And if we understand real dharma, which is called Dharmam Bhagavatam, Bhagavad Dharma, there are many dharmas. There is dharma of the body, Deha Dharma. There is dharma of the family, Kula Dharma. There is dharma of the country, desh dharma. There are many dharmas. There is dharma to obtain artha, economic development, sense gratification within the boundaries of dharma. So there is kama. So all those things are there. There is moksha dharma. But beyond all that is jaiva dharma, also known as bhagavad dharma. And it is this bhagavad dharma that Srila Prabhupada is teaching us in this Krishna consciousness movement called ISKCON. So this dharmam bhagavatam, bhagavad dharma, if we understand, then we will develop love for Krishna. Liberation will come as a byproduct. And most importantly, we will return home, back home, back to Godhead to eternally serve Krishna in the spiritual realm. So what is this Bhagavad Dharma, my dear friends? What is this real dharma that only the 12 Mahajans know by Krishna's mercy? Verse number 22. Etavaneva lokesmin humsam dharma parahasmritaha bhakti yogo bhagavati tannama grahanadibhi. Very beautiful verse. Srila Prabhupada translates, devotional service, bhakti yogo bhagavati, devotional service for Krishna. So devotional service beginning with Bhagavati means Supreme Personality of Godhead, and Tan Naam means Krishna's Naam, Krishna's name. Grahana means to chant, and Adi means and others, like chanting, hearing, worshipping, glorifying, etc. So devotional service beginning with the chanting of the holy names of the Lord is the ultimate religious principle for the living entity in human society. So my dear friends of New Panyati Dham, the mission of our life is mentioned in this beautiful verse of Srimad Bhagavatam. Devotional service beginning with the chanting of the holy name of Krishna is the ultimate religious principle for the living entity in human society. Etavaneva lokesmin humsam dharma parah smrita. So if someone asks, what is the parah dharma? What is the supreme dharma? For all human beings, pumsam means human beings. Pumsam dharma para smritaha. What is recognized as a supreme dharma for us? It is bhakti yogo bhagavati. Krishna consciousness. Krishna bhakti. Bhakti yogo bhagavati. Okay, so how do you practice this bhakti? Tan nama grahana adidhi. It begins with chanting and hearing the holy names of Krishna. Aha, what a beautiful lesson. So then we'll go to the last verse, next verse. Text number 23. Shri Yamraji further elaborates, Namocharana Mahatmyam Hare Paschata Putrakaha Ajami Lopi Yenaiva Mrutyu Pashada Muchata. Translation, my dear servants, you are as good as my sons. Just see how glorious is the chanting of the holy name of the Lord. The greatly sinful Ajamil chanted only to call his son, not knowing that he was chanting the Lord's holy name. Nevertheless, by chanting the holy name of the Lord, he remembered Narayan. And thus, he was immediately saved from the Yamapash, the ropes of death. Aha, Mrutyu Pashad Amuchata. He was immediately released from Yamapash. By Namocharan. Just by chanting the holy name. Whose holy name? Hare. The holy name of the Supreme Lord, Hari, Sarva Amangala Hare Iti Hari. So we will read this purport and then we will stop. Purport by Srila Prabhupada. Very beautiful purport. There is no need to conduct research into the significance of the chanting of the Hare Krishna Mahamantra. The history of Ajamil is sufficient proof of the power of the Lord's holy name and the exalted position of a person who chants the holy name incessantly. My dear friends, it is not just 16 rounds. Our International Society for Krishna Consciousness is not a society of 16 rounds. Please, Srila Prabhupada has said that is the very bare minimum. Very bare minimum to show that we are serious. And then our spiritual life begins with initiation. Initiation means to initiate. Initiation means beginning. We have to come to the platform of Kirtaniya Sadahari, constantly chanting. Srila Prabhupada has clearly written here. These are Srila Prabhupada's pure words. the history. So there is no need to conduct research into the significance of chanting of the Hare Krishna. Now we as doctors are conducting certain research in US, also in Bhaktivedanta Hospital in Mumbai, about the effects of the medical effects of Hare Krishna Mahamantra, and the findings are very encouraging, very positive. But mind you, this is not for us. This is for the purpose of preaching. For people who have not read Srimad Bhagavatam and Chaitanya Charitamrita and Bhagavad Gita, it is for them, because they have more faith in scientific research, randomized, double-blinded, controlled trials. Hare Krishna. It is for them, not for us. For us, the praman, the evidence, is not medical scientific research. It is Srimad Bhagavatam. Srila Prabhupada ji is saying there is no need to conduct research into the significance of chanting of the Hare Krishna mantra, which means we should be fully convinced. It is for preaching purposes that we are doing that research. Sometimes I have seen devotees get very excited. Oh, this research was done and it reduces depression scores. And those are not the real benefits. Srila Haridas Thakur will be very heartbroken if we start talking about reduction in depression level and depression scores and other things by chanting the Hare Krishna Mahamantra. Hare Krishna Mahamantra is the Yugala Mantra. It is meant to take us to the highest realm, Goloka Vrindavan, to eternally engage in the service of Shri Shri Radha Krishna, in the five main rasas. So that is the real purpose of chanting Hare Krishna, to awaken Krishna Prema. Nitya Siddha Krishna Prema Sadhya Kabunoye Shravan Adi Shuddha Chitti Kariyo. Shravan Kirtanam, by doing that, our love for Krishna will be awakened. That is the real purpose. The history of Ajamil is sufficient proof of the power of the Lord's holy name and the exalted position of a person who chants the holy name incessantly. We have to chant incessantly, constantly, while doing all our work, silently within our mouth, our tongue should softly vibrate the Hare Krishna Mahamantra. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. This requires abhyas. This requires practice, and we have to do this practice. We have to increase our Naam Bhajan, increase our number of rounds, and we should not talk Prajalpa. We should constantly chant the Hare Krishna Mahamantra while bathing, while falling off to sleep, while sitting, while driving, while walking. We should try to chant as much as possible. Incessantly, Srila Prabhupada says, the holy name should never leave our tongue. Therefore, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu advised, Harer Nama, Harer Nama, Harer Nama Eva Kevalam, Kalo Nastyeva, Nastyeva, Nastyeva Gatiranyatha. In this age of Kali, no one can perform all the ritualistic ceremonies for becoming liberated. That is extremely difficult. Therefore, all the Shastras and all the Acharyas have recommended unanimously that in this age, one chant the holy name. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna. So we just saw very clearly that Yamaraji, who is one of the 12 Mahajans, one of the authorities, he's a supreme judge in this material universe, he is saying that dharma is what is taught by the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Dharmam tu sakshat bhagavat pran. Krishna teaches what is dharma. In Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says that paritranaya sadhunam vinashaya cha dushkritam dharma samsthapanarthaya sambhavami yuga yuga. I come in every yuga as yuga avatar to establish dharma, to protect the devotees and to punish the miscreants. So Krishna establishes dharma. Krishna tells us what is dharma. And Krishna has revealed this dharma, bhagavata dharma, jayava dharma, paradharma, parodharma, athap pumbir dvija shreshta varanashrama vibhagashah swanuchishastha dharmasya samsiddhir haritoshanam. What is dharma samsiddhir, perfection of dharma? Haritoshanam, to please Krishna. Pleasing Krishna is the highest dharma. And then Yamaraj is saying there are 12 Mahajans who know this supreme dharma, Bhagavad dharma. I am one of them. And then what is that dharma? That dharma is to incessantly chant Harinam. Clearly it is mentioned in Bhagavatam. Chanting, hearing, worshipping. Tannam Grahana. So we have to chant the holy name of Krishna. That is a supreme dharma. Okay. So now we are convinced that our dharma is to chant the Hare Krishna Mahamantra. Chant the holy name of Krishna. Okay, so are there any rules and regulations? Is there a mood that we should chant in? Yes. And the Yuga Avatar for Kali Yuga, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, is teaching us this in the pages of Sri Chaitanya Charitamrit, Antya Leela, and this is chapter number 20th, the last chapter of Chaitanya Charitamrit, entitled the Shikshashtakam Prayers. And we are in verse number 25. Srila Krishna Das Kaviraj Goswami is telling us that how Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wants us to chant.
উত্তম হইয়া বৈষ্ণব হবে নিরভিমান জীবে সম্মান দিব জানি কৃষ্ণ অধিষ্ঠান. Although a Vaishnava is the most exalted person, he is prideless and gives all respect to everyone, knowing everyone to be the resting place of Krishna. Actually, let's go back. Yeah, let's go back a little bit. This is the verse. So here, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is saying in verse number 20 of the 20th chapter of Antirila of Sri Chaitanya Charitamrita, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu speaking to Swarup Damodar Goswami and Ramananda Raya. Ye rupe laile naam prema upajaye tahara lakshana shuna Swarup Ramaraya. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu continued, O Swarup Damodar Goswami and Ramananda Raya, hear from me the symptoms of how one should chant the Hare Krishna Mahamantra to awaken very easily one's dormant love for Krishna. Nitya Siddha Krishna Prem. Sadhya Kabunoye Shravanadi Shuddha Chitti Koriye Udaye. How there will be Premudaye. How there will be awakening of our Krishna Prem by chanting Hare Krishna Mahamantra. What is the mood? How should we chant? Mahaprabhu is saying, listen. Listen, Swarup Damodar Goswami. Listen, Ramanandra. I will tell you how one has to chant. Then Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is saying, Trinadapi Suni Chena Taro Riva Sahishnuna Amani Namana Dena Kirtaniya Sadahari. One who thinks himself lower than the grass, one who is more tolerant than a tree, and who does not expect personal honor, but is always prepared to give all respect to others, can very easily always chant the holy name of the Lord. So four things are mentioned here in order to incessantly chant. Prabhupada said we have to always chant, incessantly chant the holy name of Krishna. To do that, there are four things we have to do. One is, one has to be humble, very humble, like the grass. One has to be very tolerant, like a tree. One should not expect any personal honor or respect. We should be prideless. And one should be always prepared to give all honor and respect to others. Such a person can very easily chant the name of Krishna constantly. It becomes easy. Srila Prabhupada said, Krishna consciousness is simple for the simple. So if we are simple, we are humble, we are tolerant, we are prideless and we are respectful, then we will be able to chant Premanam. Premanam. Our aim is Premanam. We want to chant Shuddhanam. Mahaprabhu elaborates. Uttamahaya apna ke mane trinadhama dui prakare sahishnuta kare vrikshasam. These are the symptoms of one who chants the Hare Krishna Mahamantra. The symptoms that were mentioned in the previous verse. Humility, tolerance, pridelessness and respectfulness. Although he is uttama, he is very exalted, he thinks himself lower than the grass on the ground. And like a tree, he tolerates everything in two ways. Dui prakare sahishnuta kare vriksha sama. There are two ways how trees demonstrate their tolerance. Next verse. Vrikshaye na kati leha kichu na bolaye shukhai ya mai leha kare pani na mago. When a tree is cut down, vrikshaye na kati leha kichu na bolaye, doesn't say anything. When you cut a tree, the tree will not protest. When a tree is cut down, it does not protest. And even when drying up, it does not ask anyone for water. Shukhaya mai leha kare pani na magai. Doesn't ask for water. So two ways. Doesn't protest and doesn't hanker. So my dear friends, we have two important lessons to learn from the tree. We should not complain. Hare Krishna. Very difficult, right? The tendency is to put blame. What to do? Things are not good because this devotee did that. That devotee did this. This is the problem with this. You know, very easy to sit down and point fingers at others, especially point fingers at the leaders. Very easy to do that and complain. I am not making spiritual advancement. What to do? There are no good speakers. What to do? There are no, nobody is preaching. Very easy to sit down and just point fingers and complain. But that is not what Mahaprabhu wants us to do. That is not what Srila Prabhupada wants us to do. A tree does not protest. Hare Krishna. Doesn't make give excuses, doesn't protest, and doesn't make unnecessary demands. Doesn't, even when drying, does not make demands for water. You have to learn this from the tree. This is not a preference. This is not an option. This is a principle. The Shikshashtakam prayers are the principles laid down by Mahaprabhu for us. These are the only 8 verses he gave us. And our entire Krishna consciousness movement, Krishna consciousness means Krishna Chaitanya. Our whole movement is Srila Prabhupada is Gauravani Pracharine. He's preaching Gauravani. And Gauranga Mahaprabhu gave these 8 verses. So these are not options. These are not preferences. You see, in Krishna consciousness, there are principles and there are preferences. There are 2 P's, principles and preferences. Should we chant 16 rounds? Yes, that's a principle. 4 regulative, not preferences, not options. 4 regulative principles. No meat eating, no intoxication, no illicit sex, no gambling. These are compulsory. Fasting on Ekadashi, it's a principle. Being humble, tolerant, respectful, practicing Vaishnava etiquettes. This is a principle. Now, how long the Shikha should be? That's a preference. That's a preference. Whether we wear gopi skirt, gopi dress, or whether we wear a sari, that's a preference. So there are certain things that are preference. Ekadashi, should we do nirjala or should we do sajala? Should we eat fruits on Ekadashi or should we do nirjala? That's a matter of personal preference. So there are many things that are a matter of personal preference. But there are certain things that are principles. And these, my dear friends, the Shikshashtakam, especially this verse that Mahaprabhu said, tied around your neck, like a neck beads, and then chant Hare Krishna. This is a principle. Mahaprabhu is telling us, don't complain, don't make excuses, and don't hanker. If I get this, I will chant. If there is a Kirtan festival, I will do Kirtan. Otherwise, no. If someone arranges Harikatha, then I will read Prabhupada's books. I will hear Bhagavatam. Otherwise, no. I will not take the effort of going on ISKCON Desire Tree or YouTube and hearing Harikatha. No. If there is a Katha, then I will hear. Otherwise, I will not hear. No. We cannot make unnecessary demands, cannot complain. We have to take ownership for our own spiritual development. Verse number 24. Jai Jai Ma Gaye Tare Deya Pandhana Dharma Vrishti Sahe Ane Karaye Rakshana. Jai Jai Magaye Tare Deya Apana Dhana. The tree does not eat its own fruits but gives them to anyone who comes to get them. The tree delivers its fruits, flowers, and whatever else, dhan, wealth it possesses, to anyone and everyone. And Dharma Vrishti Sahe Anera Karaye Rakshana. It tolerates scorching heat and torrents of rain, yet it gives shelter to others. When it is hot, the tree bears the heat but gives shade to those who take shelter under it. When it is raining, the tree will take the beating, like today it was raining in Atlanta, but gives protection and shelter, rakshana, to those who take shelter. So this is the quality of a tree that Mahaprabhu wants us to cultivate. Uttama haya Vaishnava habe nirabhimana jive samman dibe jani Krishna adhishtana. Although Vaishnava is the most exalted person, Uttama haya Vaishnava, he is nirabhiman. He is prideless, amanina, and gives all respect to everyone, knowing everyone to be a resting place of Krishna. Jive sammana dibe, gives respect to everyone. How and why? Jani Krishna adhishtan. Ishwara sarva bhutana mridadeshi arjuna tishtha. Sarvasya chaham ridhi sannivishto. Krishna is there in everyone's heart. Considering this, gives respect to everyone. Mahaprabhu continues. Ei mata hayajai Krishna namalaya Shri Krishna Charane Tara Prema Upajaya. Such a beautiful verse. Ei Mata Hayajai Krishna Namalaya Shri Krishna Charane Tara Prema Upajaya. If one chants the holy name of Lord Krishna in this manner, Ei Mate Hayajai Krishna Namalaya. If we chant in the spirit of tolerance, humility, pridelessness and respectfulness, Shri Krishna Charane Tara Prema Upajaya. He will certainly awaken his dormant love for Lord Krishna's lotus feet. Aha. Tara Madhya Sarva Shrestha Nama Sankirtan Nirapradhe Nama Laile Pave Prema Dhan. Hare Krishna. So this is the mood in which we have to chant. So now this is clear. What is clear? Who are the 12 Mahajans? Is clear. What is Bhagavad Dharma? It is devotion to Krishna, and it is begins with chanting and hearing about Krishna. This is clear. All right. And who knows this? The 12 Mahajans know it. How do they know it? By Krishna's mercy, they know it. All right. So now let's start today's discussion. Today we'll talk about Lord Brahma. So now let us see, my dear friends, if Lord Brahma is a Mahajan, does he exemplify these qualities of taking shelter of Bhagavad Dharma and exemplifying these four qualities that Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wants? Trinadapi Sunichena, humility. Taror Iva Sahishnuna, tolerance. Amanina, pridelessness, not expecting any respect for oneself. And Manadena, respectfulness. And Kirtaniya Sadahari, in this mood, always chanting Harina, always doing Nam Bhajan. Does Lord Brahma exemplify these qualities? Let us take a look. So we'll go on a journey of exploring these four qualities. So first quality, humility. When Lord Brahma committed a mistake, every jiva is prone to committing mistakes. When Brahmaji committed a mistake, Lord Krishna, in a very playful way, he killed a very, very powerful demon called Aghasur. He was the brother of Bakasur and Putana. And he not only wanted to kill Krishna, but he wanted to kill all the friends of Krishna, so that having lost all their children, all the Brajvasis will also die. So he wanted to create mass destruction in Vraja. He wanted to kill everyone. He knew if Krishna and his friends die, Yashoda Maiya, Ananda Maharaj, Radha Rani, all the Gopas and Gopis, elder Gopas and Gopis in Vrindavan, and all the calves are dead, then the cows, everyone will die. So he wanted to kill all the calves, he wanted to kill all the Gopa friends of Krishna, and he wanted to kill Krishna on the day of Balramji's birthday. That too. Hare Krishna. What a cruel fellow, Aghasur. Very powerful demon. Even the demigods, devatas, were scared of him. But Krishna very easily, playfully killed him. And also brought his dead friends and calves back to life. Revived them. Very playfully. Without any effort. Ishwara Parama Krishna Satchidananda Vigraha Anadir Adir Govinda Sarva Karana Karana. Krishna can do anything. He's the cause of all causes. He's the Supreme Lord. He killed. But in the form of a small child. So all the devatas came and they started showering flowers. And the news reached Brahmaji that there is a small boy in Vraja who has killed Aghasur. He brought back his dead friends to life. So Brahmaji came to see. And what did Brahmaji see? In the beautiful forest of Vrindavan, the dead 12-mile-long snake Aghasur is lying dead in the forest of Vrindavan. Now only his skin is there. And close by, in the beautiful forest of Vrindavan, Lord Krishna is sitting as a little 5-year-old boy. He's still finishing his Kaumara Leela, his Balya Leela. And Pauganda Leela has not started. Pauganda Leela is 1 year away still. So Krishna is sitting as a 5-year-old boy, like the whorl of a lotus. 10th canto of Bhagavatam describes this. And around him, like the petals of the lotus flower, all his friends are sitting in circles around him. And every friend feels that Krishna is looking at me. Every friend feels that Krishna is eating from my tiffin. Everyone is feeding Krishna very happily. And Krishna is accepting. And they are eating from each other's plate. So Brahmaji thinks that Krishna, Supreme Lord Vishnu, is Yajna Bhuk. He eats only what is offered very purely from the Yajnas, fire sacrifices, by very qualified Brahmanas. And these boys belonging to the Vaishya community are feeding their jhuta, what they have already eaten, their uchishta, to Krishna. And Krishna is eating happily. And you know what were the plates in the forest? There were no foam plates and paper plates or metal plates. Lord Brahmaji said, in Vaikuntha, I have seen Lakshmi Devi, Srimati Lakshmi Devi, serving Lord Narayan on a golden plate. And here Krishna is keeping his food on rocks. Krishna's plates are the rocks. His table, dining table, is a rock. His plates are the leaves that have fallen from the trees of Vrindavan. And then, or they are using some cloth as their plate. They're putting their samosas on a cloth and eating and sharing. So friend is taking one bite of samosa and putting. Krishna has some buttermilk with him and a friend steals his buttermilk and drinks it and has got Krishna's buttermilk in his mouth with his cheeks blown with buttermilk. And Krishna goes in front of the friend, asks him, did you take my buttermilk? And the friend says, but there is buttermilk in his mouth, Krishna's buttermilk. So Krishna squeezes the cheeks of that friend and from his mouth, all the buttermilk splashes on Krishna's face. And Krishna licks it from the mouth of his friend, buttermilk. Brahmaji is bewildered seeing this. A bumblebee comes and Madhu Mangal is sitting next to Krishna. Madhu Mangal, Madhu means bumblebee, and here is a Madhu, a bumblebee. So Krishna puts his hand on Madhu Mangal and says, Madhu, look, a Madhu has come. And then Krishna addresses the honeybee. Madhu, have you come to kill this Madhu? Have you come to attack this Madhu? And then he tells Madhu Mangal, Madhu Mangal, my friend, don't worry, you are my friend. I will protect you from this honeybee. There are such childish talks are going on in Brahma. Just bewildered. This cannot be the Supreme Lord. I must test him. Otherwise, the whole world will be cheated. They are considering this boy as a Supreme Lord, but he might just be an ordinary boy. I must test him for the welfare of the world so that the world is not cheated. Is he really God? So by Brahmaji's arrangement, the calves, they wander away to eat grass and Brahmaji steals them. That Krishna tells his friends, don't worry, I will find the calves. You just sit here and continue eating lunch. I'll be right back. Krishna goes, Brahmaji comes and steals the friends also. Now Krishna has lost his calves. Krishna has lost his friends. But Krishna is all powerful. Krishna can never be cheated. Krishna cheats the greatest of cheaters. Immediately Krishna expands himself as all the friends, all the calves, the color, the nature, the size of each and every calf was exactly as it was when Brahmaji stole them. Exact copies Krishna created. And no 3D printing. Krishna actually created real calves. And then all his friends, exact same voice, same appearance, same clothes. Our Acharya said that even the mud stains that were there on the clothes, on the dhotis of these Gopa friends of Krishna, they were also exactly like that. And for 1 year, Krishna carried on as if nothing happened. There are many, many internal reasons why Krishna did this pastime. One pastime was once when Krishna ate Vrajraj. Balramji and all the friends had complained. Krishna said, now I will eat Vrajraj for one full year in the form of all these calves. When they're eating grass, they're eating Vrajraj also. And no one will be able to complain because I will expand myself as all these calves. And then all the elder gopis wanted to have Krishna as their son. And Krishna wanted to fulfill their desire. So Krishna expanded himself as all those boys. And he went and lived in the homes of all the elder gopas and gopis as their son for one full year. There were many wonderful internal reasons why Krishna manifested it pastime. But after 1 year when Brahmaji came, which was only a moment for him, he hid them and came back in earth. 1 year had passed and he saw nothing has changed. It's business as usual. Krishna has not been affected by my trickery. So Brahmaji immediately realized that Krishna has outsmarted me. Krishna has outwitted me. Krishna is Supreme Personality of Godhead. Oh, Krishna, what a grave mistake I have made. Actually, not a mistake, but I have committed apradh. I have committed a great Vaishnava apradh because all these boys are great devotees of Krishna. All the calves are great devotees of Krishna. And I took them away from Krishna. What a grievous offense. The greatest offense one can commit is to take a devotee away from his Ishtadev. And that is what I have done. I am such an apradhi. And Brahmaji was filled with guilt and remorse. And he offered beautiful prayers. Chapter 14 of the 10th canto of Srimad Bhagavatam offered wonderful prayers. So this is the quality of Brahmaji, his humility. Because we all make mistakes. As Mahajan Brahmaji is teaching us the principle of humility. When we make a mistake and we realize it, we must have the humility to own it. Brahmaji goes in front of Lord Krishna and admits his guilt, admits his mistake and offers beautiful prayers which constitute a full chapter in the 10th canto. Chapter 14, very beautiful prayers he offers and begs forgiveness, admits his mistake. So this is important, my dear friends. We all make mistakes. We all have made mistakes and we all will make mistakes. Hare Krishna. It should humble us. And one symptom of humility is that we admit. It is said, to err is human, To admit is humility. To err is human, to admit is humble. And humility is a very important quality that attracts Krishna. So Brahmaji is teaching that principle. Second principle, tolerance. It is mentioned by Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur Mahashaya in Navadvip Dham Mahatmya, in the Parikrama Khanda of Sri Navadvip Dham Mahatmya, 5.143 to 144. When Brahmaji committed this grave offense against Krishna and the Brajvasis, especially the Gopas and the calves, at the end of Dwapar Yuga, this happened. So at the end of Dwapar Yuga, Brahmaji, after doing Abhishek of Krishna and begging forgiveness, offering prayers, Brahmaji came to Navadvip Dham. He came to Antardvip in Sri Navadvip Mandal. And there, with great guilt and remorse in his heart, he performed austerities to beg forgiveness from Krishna. And it is said that Lord Krishna gave darshan to Lord Brahma in Antardvip, in Navadvip Dham, and appeared to him in the form of Sri Gauranga Mahaprabhu. So Krishna came as Gauranga Mahaprabhu and gave darshan to our Mahajan, Lord Brahmaji. And Brahmaji prayed at that time to Sri Gauranga Mahaprabhu. Ei matra tava pade prarthana amara prakata lilaya jena hai parivar. Oh my dear Gauranga Mahaprabhu, oh my dear Krishna Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, my dear Krishna, in Kali Yuga you will appear as Gauranga Mahaprabhu. At that time, prakata lilaya jena hai parivar. I want to be born as one of your associates when you come next time. This time I made a big mistake. You appeared in my Brahmanda, and as your Chaturmukhi Brahma, I committed a grievous offense against you and your devotees. So I messed it up. See, we all make mistakes. Brahma is asking for a second chance. When you come next time, give me another chance, please. He's praying. And I want to be Haya Parivar. I want to be born as one of your Parivar, in your Parivar, in your Bhakta Samaj. I want to be one of your Parshads, one of your associates. And Ei Matra Tava Pade Prarthana Amar. This is my humble petition and prayer. I'm begging at your lotus feet. Please, next time when you do Prakati Leela, I want to be there with you as your Parshad, as your associate. Brahma Buddhi Dure Jai. Hena janma paay, tomara sangete thaki tava guna gaay. Please listen carefully, my dear friend. This is very sweet. These are the nectar-like sweet amrit drops coming from the pen of Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Brahmaji is praying to Sri Gauranga Mahaprabhu. Brahma buddhi dure jaay. I am engaged in management. I am a manager of this universe. And because I'm engaged in management, I committed great Vaishnava Aparad and Vishnu Aparad. I offended you and I offended your devotees. Next time when I come, I don't want management position. Hare Krishna, our managers can really relate to this. There is so much headache, so much contamination in management. Brahma is saying, I don't want to become a manager in the next time you come, in your next Prakati Leela. Brahma Buddhi Dure Jaya. Because I have Brahma Buddhi, that I am the controller of the universe, I am the manager, I committed offense. So next time, I don't want any management position. I want to be Bhajanandi. Brahma Buddhi Dure Jaya. Hena Janma Pai. I want such a birth where I am not a manager. I don't want to be a controller. Brahma Buddhi Nahi Chahiye. Dure Jaya. Tomara Sangete Thaki Tava Guna Gaya. What I want to do? Tava guna gai. I just want to Krishnot kirtana gana naratana paro. I just want to sing your glories. Tava guna gai. Hearing Brahmaji's prayers, our Gaurasundar replied. Three beautiful verses. Sri Navadvip Dham Mahatmya, chapter 5, 146 to 148. Please listen, my dear friends, and relish. This is the condensed milk that we are drinking before we sleep tonight. This is our bedtime beautiful nectar. Je samaye mama lila prakata haibe yavanera grihe tumi janamalabhibe. Gauranga Mahaprabhu is telling Brahmaji, Je samaye mama lila prakata haibe. When I will be doing my prakata lila as Gauranga Mahaprabhu in Kali Yuga, Yavanera grihe tumi janama labhibe. You will take birth in a Yavana family, family of meat eaters, a low class family. You will take birth. You are saying that you don't want a high birth, you don't want Brahma Buddhi, you want to be humble. Okay, I will give you birth in the next yuga when I come in a Yavana kul. Yavanera grihe tumi janama labhibe. आपनाके हिना बलि हई बेगेयाना हरिदास हबे तुमी शून्य अभिमान. श्री गौरांग महाप्रभु इज मेकिंग दिस प्रेडिक्शन. ही सेज आपनाके हिना बलि हई बेगेया. यू विल कंसिडर योर सेल्फ टू बी वेरी वेरी फॉलन. यू विल नॉट हैव एनी प्राइड. यू विल बी प्राइडलेस एंड हरिदास हबे तुमी शून्य अभिमान. यू विल बी नोन एज हरिदास ठाकुर. So who is Brahmaji in Gaur Lila? He is Haridas Thakur. Direct evidence is there in Shri Navadvip Dham Mahatmya. Apanake hina boli hai begeyana Haridas habe tumi shunya abhimana. You will be Haridas and you will be shunya abhimana. You will not have any pride. You will be prideless. Now listen, my dear friend, this is ecstatic. Tina laksha hari nama jivhagre nachi be nirana samaye tumi amake dekhi be. Shri Gauranga Mahaprabhu is saying, Tina laksha hari nama jivhagre nachi be. On the tip of your tongue, 3 lakh holy names, 3 lakh Krishna nama will dance every day. Hari bol, 192 rounds. And Niryana samaye tumi. At the time of death, amake dekhibe. When you die, you will have my darshan. I will be there with you at the time of your departure, just like I was there for Bhishma Dev. Hari Hari. Tina laksha hari nama jivhagre nachibe. Niryana samaye tumi amake dekhibe. Haridas Thakur Mahashay ki jai, Shri Brahmaji ki jai. So this is our Lord Brahma, Mahajan. Came as Thakur Mahashay, Haridas Thakur. 22 marketplaces. He was beaten up by the Yavanas. His own clan people, people of his own community were beating. Because he was behaving like a Hindu, chanting Hare Krishna Mahamantra, chanting the names of the Hindu gods. And what did the Hindus do? They said, we don't accept this fellow. He's a Musalman. We don't accept. So Hindus said, we don't want him. And the Muslims said, he's a blot on our religion. We don't want him. They wanted to kill him. And after killing him, did they want to bury him underground? No. No. The Qazi said, if we bury him, according to the Islamic rituals, he will get Jannat. He will get heaven. We don't want him. So he cannot be buried. And what did the Hindus say? No, we cannot give him to Agni. If we offer him to Agni, we cremate him, we put him in fire, then Agni Dev will give him liberation. He will get higher destination if you burn him. No. Because what is a cremation? Cremation is your last offering to Krishna. Now I have nothing, I am offering my body to you. That is the whole meaning of cremation. We offer it to Agni and Agni Dev carries us to Krishna. But no, we cannot do that because he is not a Hindu. Just throw him in the river. He was humiliated, he was ill-treated, he was beaten in 22 marketplaces. The streets in the 22 marketplaces were smeared with the blood of Thakur Haridas. But he was tolerant. He was tolerant. He was praying to Krishna to forgive the executioners. To forgive the executioners. Please give them Krishna. He was not saying just forgive them. Give them Krishna frame. He was praying. Give them Krishna frame. This is the love and the tolerance of Thakur Mahashaya, Haridas Thakur. Amani. Third, so second was tolerance. First was humility, and we spoke about how he owned his mistake and begged forgiveness. And second is tolerance as Thakur Haridas. And third quality is Amani, not expecting any respect for oneself. You will recollect, my dear friends, last month we were discussing Jagannath Katha. Remember? And we spoke about the history of Lord Jagannath. In that we saw how the deity of Nila Madhav in Neelachal, when Brahmaji became 50 years old, Nila Madhav went to Brahmalok to be worshipped by Lord Brahma for the next 50 years. And in Neelachal, another deity manifested, the deity of Jagannath, which will be there for the next 50 years of Brahmaji's life. We saw that. So when Maharaj Indradyumna wanted to establish that temple in Jagannath Puri, the temple of Jagannath Balabhadra Subhadra, Narad Muni says, who is going to install the deities? Who is going to do prana pratishthapana? So Narad Muni told Maharaj Indradyumna that come, let's go to Satyalok, let's go to Brahmalok, and we'll invite Brahmaji, who is the father. He is the original worshipper of Nilamata. So let us bring him and he will install the deity of Jagannath. So Indradyumna Maharaj and Narad Muni, they go to Brahmalok and they request Brahmaji. And then Brahmaji comes and installs the deity of Jagannath Balabhadra Subhadra. So who has done the prana pratishthapana of Jagannath Balabhadra Subhadra in Jagannath Puri? It is Lord Brahma. Just process this. It is Lord Brahma who did a prana pratishthapana. That same Brahmaji comes as Thakur Haridas in Kali Yuga. And see how he is treated. He was not even allowed to enter the temple of that Jagannath. As Brahmaji, he has brought those deities, he has done the prana pratishthapana, he has installed them. And now that Haridas Thakur, who is Brahmaji, is not even allowed to come near. He has to stay far away in Siddha Bukul and just be satisfied by taking darshan of the chakra on top of the temple. Amanina. Not expecting any respect. He never once said, Mahaprabhu, can you just talk to the pandas and take me inside for darshan? Never. Amanina. I don't deserve. This is the third quality of our Mahajan Brahmaji. Just think about this. So humble. Then, manadena. His quality of giving respect to others. Manadena to other devotees. So we have to go back to Sri Chaitanya Charitamrit Antelila, chapter entitled, The Passing Away of Thakur Haridas. Haridas Thakur is speaking to Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Now he is very old. You see, Haridas Thakur was 35 years elder to Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And at this time, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is around 40 years old. So Haridas Thakur is 35 years. So he's 75 to 80 years old, Haridas Thakur. He's an old man. Now he's speaking to Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Sei lila prabhu more kabhu na dekhai ba apanara age mora sharira padi. Srila Haridas Thakur is praying to Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in Antya Leela. Sei Leela Prabhu More Kabhu Na Dekhai. My dear Lord, I wish that you do not show me your Leela of winding up your pastimes in this material. Don't show me your disappearance, Leela. Mahaprabhu, I cannot bear to see you disappear from this world. Apanara Age Mora Sharira Padipa. I want my body to die in front of you, in your presence. Apanara age mora sharira padiba. Let my body fall. Before that time comes, when you demonstrate, when you manifest your disappearance, Leela, my dear Mahaprabhu, kindly let my body fall down in your presence. Ridaye dharimu tomar kamala charana nayane dekhimu tomar chandavadana. Ridaye dharimu tomar kamala charana. I want to hold your lotus feet to my heart. I want to hold your lotus feet to my heart. In the mood of the gopis, in the gopi geet, the gopis are praying that, my dear Krishna, we hold your lotus feet to our heart. Yatte sujata charanam buruham staneshu. Hold your lotus feet to our heart, my dear Krishna. The gopis are praying. Yatte sujata charanam buruham staneshu. Bhita shanoe priyadadhi mahikar kasheshu. Tenata vimata sitad bhote nakim suet. Kurpadi bhir brahmati dhir bhavada yushamna. When you walk in the forest, the thorns and the sharp pebbles will prick and pierce your soft lotus feet. Therefore, let us keep your lotus feet on our heart. Ridaye dharimo tomar kamala charana. When I die, my dear Sri Krishna Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, I want to keep your soft lotus feet, your kamala charana, your lotus feet on my heart. Nayane dekhimu tomar chanda vadana. And I want to see your lotus, your moon-like face, chanda vadana. Vadana means face and chanda means moon. I want to see Tomara Chanda Vadana when I die. What a perfection of life. to die seeing the moonlike face of Gaurachandra, Shri Gaurachandra. Jihaya uccharimu tomar Krishna Chaitanya naam, ei mata mora ichha chhadimu param. Jihaya uccharimu tomar Krishna Chaitanya naam. With my tongue I want to chant your name, Shri Krishna Chaitanya. Shri is Shri Ji, Radharani. Krishna is our Bhagwan, Krishna. And Shri and Krishna, Shri Ji and Krishna has combined as Chaitanya. Shri Krishna Chaitanya, Radha Krishna Nahi Anya. Shri Krishna Chaitanya. I want to chant your name, Shri Krishna Chaitanya, with my tongue. Ei mata mora ichha chhadimu parana. Kindly let me give up my body in this way. Chanting your name, Shri Krishna Chaitanya, holding your Charana Kamal, your lotus feet to my heart, and gazing, beholding your beautiful moon-like face, my dear Gaura Sundar, Gaura Chandra. Mora e ichha jadi tomar prasadehaya e nivedana mora kara dayamaya. O dayamaya, O most merciful Lord, if possible, please grant my desire. Mora e ichha jadi tomar prasadehaya. Please fulfill this desire. This is my desire. In interest of time, we are going to go a little fast. We'll skip one verse. So then what did Mahaprabhu reply?
Prabhu ko he haridas, ye tumi magi be, Krishna kripa maya taha, avashya kari be.
As Krishna, I had already promised you this, that this will come to pass. This will happen, my dear Haridas. As Brahmaji, when you had prayed, I have already given you this benediction. So yes, my dear Haridas, Krishna is so merciful that he must execute whatever you want. Mahaprabhu replied. But Mahaprabhu said,
Kintu amar ye kichu shukha sabato malaya tomara yogya nahe abe amare chariya.
Kintu amar ye kichu shukha sabato malaya. You are the source of all happiness. Whatever happiness is mine is all due to your association. Tomar yogya nahe, yave amare chhadiya. It is not fitting that you go away and leave me behind. Mahaprabhu is telling Haridas Thakur. Now what does Haridas Thakur reply? Thakur Mahashaya says,
Charane dhari kahe Haridas, nakariha maya, avashyamo adhame prabhu karae daya.
Catching the lotus feet of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, our frail old Haridas Thakur said, my Lord, do not create an illusion. Na kariha maya. Do not create an illusion. Although I am so fallen, mo adhame, you must certainly show me this mercy. Please, karai daya, show me your mercy. Now see, this is the manadena. This is the quality of Brahmaji as Haridas Thakur showing respect to others.
Mora shiro mani kata kata mahashaya tomara lilara sahai koti bhakta haya.
My Lord, there are many respectable personalities. Millions of devotees. Koti bhakta haya. Millions of devotees.
Mora shiro mani,
who are fit to sit on my head. They are all helping you in your pastimes. Tomara lila sahai koti bhakta. They are very great devotees qualified to sit on my head and they are assisting you in your pastimes. Throughout, this was the mood of Haridas Thakur, who is Lord Brahma. Mana dena. Seeing the good in other devotees. When Sanatan Goswami was suffering from skin disease and his ulcers were oozing and bleeding, Mahaprabhu told Sanatan Goswami, don't commit suicide because your body is mine.
Diksha kale bhakta kare atma samarpana sei kale Krishna tare kore atma sam.
When I initiated you, diksha kale bhakta kare atma samarpana, you have surrendered yourself to me at the time of initiation. You are mine. Your body is mine. So don't commit suicide. I will use this body in my service. Your body belongs to me. Don't commit suicide. So Mahaprabhu did nished. He forbade Sanatan Goswami from committing suicide. When Mahaprabhu left, Haridas Thakur told Sanatan Goswami,
प्रभु को हे तोमार देह मोरा निज धन तोमा समा भाग्यवान नाही को न जाना।
हरिदास ठाकुर टोल्ड सनातन गोस्वामी, माय डियर सनातन,
प्रभु को हे तोमार देह मोरा निज धन तोमा समा भाग्यवान नाही को न जाना।
No one is as fortunate as you, my dear Sanatan. Why? Because Mahaprabhu said, your body is my property. Your body is my property, but
Amar deha prabhura karyena lagila bharat bhumi janma haila deha vyartha gaila.
On the other hand, my body could never come to any use for Mahaprabhu. I have never served Mahaprabhu in any way. Unlike you, my dear Sanatan.
Amar deha prabhure karye na lagila.
I could never serve Mahaprabhu like you are serving, like you are going to serve. Therefore, Bharat bhumi janma hoila deha vyartha gaila. Even though I got a fortunate birth in the holy land of India, my birth is useless. My life is useless. Haridas Thakur.
This is mana dena. Giving all recognition and respect to Sanatan Goswami, not expecting any respect for himself.
And therefore, Haridas Thakur, Tina Laksha Hari Nama Jivhagre Nachibe. 3 lakh holy name. Constantly he was chanting. And he is Namacharya. Mahaprabhu made him the Namacharya. Therefore, Haridas Thakur, who is Lord Brahmaji, is personifying the principle of Dharma, Bhagavad Dharma, that is told to us by Yamraj in the pages of Bhagavatam. Therefore, Brahmaji is a perfect Mahajan. Brahmaji is a perfect Mahajan. When Haridas Thakur, we have come to the conclusion, last 2 minutes, please. When Haridas Thakur glorified Sanatan Goswami like this, mana dena, give all respect to him. What Sanatan Goswami said in response to Haridas Thakur's statement is, these are jewel verses from Chaitanya Charitamrita. Please drink them through your ears.
Sanatana kahe toma kebe ache ana महाप्रभुर गण तुमी महाभाग्यवान।
And हरिदास ठाकुर said that हरिदास कहे तुमा सम केवान महा that you are very fortunate, प्रभु कहे तुमार देह मोरा निज धन तुमा सम भाग्यवान है नान नहीं कोन जन। हरिदास ठाकुर told सनातन गोस्वामी, no one is fortunate like you because महाप्रभु said your body is my property. On the other hand, my life is useless.
अमार देह प्रभु रे कार्य ना लागिला
भारत भूमि जन्म होला देह व्यर्थ गईला। At that time, Sanatan Goswami replies to Haridas Thakur. He says,
Sanatana kahe toma keva ache ana Mahaprabhur gane tumi Mahabhagyavan.
Sanatan Goswami tells Haridas Thakur that toma sama keva ache ana. Who is comparable to you, Haridas Thakur? महाप्रभुर गणे तुम्ही महाभाग्यवान। यू आर महाभाग्यवान बिकॉज यू आर महाप्रभुज निज गण। आई कम टू जगन्नाथपुरी, आई लिव हियर फॉर 10 months, देन आई एम सेंट बैक टू वृंदावन। महाप्रभु कम्स टू वाराणसी, इंस्ट्रक्ट्स मी फॉर 2 months एंड देन गोज अवे। बट यू हरिदास, यू वेर विथ महाप्रभु इन नवद्वीप। महाप्रभु टुक संन्यास, यू ट्रेवल्ड विथ हिम टू जगन्नाथपुरी एंड यू आर लिविंग विथ हिम इन जगन्नाथपुरी थ्रू आउट। महाप्रभु नेवर लीव्स यू। So you are Mahaprabhur Gana Tumi Mahabhagyavan. You are very fortunate. Sanatan Goswami is giving all credit to Haridas.
Sanatana kahe toma keva ache ana Mahaprabhur Gane Tumi Mahabhagyavan.
Sanatan Goswami continues glorifying Haridas Thakur.
Apane achare keha na kare prachar, prachara kare na keha na kare achar. आचार प्रचार नामेर कर दुई कार्य तुम्ही सर्व गुरु तुम्ही जगतेर आर्य।
सनातन गोस्वामी सेस टू हरिदास ठाकुर, आपने आचार्य के है ना करे प्रचार। सम डिवोटीज हैव वेरी गुड सदाचार, दे हैव वेरी गुड साधना, वेरी गुड भजन, वेरी गुड बिहेवियर, बट ना करे प्रचार। दे हैव गुड आचरण, आचरण, बट दे डोंट डू प्रचार।
आपने आचार्य के है ना करे प्रचार एंड प्रचार करे ना के है ना करे आचार।
एंड देन देयर आर पीपल लाइक मी, Adigatha Das, who like to do prachar, but they don't have achar. They don't have good Vaishnav sadachar. They don't follow Vaishnav etiquette. They don't have good bhajan. And so, apane achare keha na kare prachar. Some have good acharan, but they don't preach. They have good practice, but don't preach. And prachar kare na keha na kare achar. Some like to preach, but they don't have good practice, devotional practice. But achara prachara namer karah dui karya tumi sarva guru tumi jagate rahay. Sanatan Goswami says, but Haridas Thakur, you are exception. Because you are a preacher and you are a practitioner, both. You have very good devotional practice and you are preaching very nicely. Therefore, tumi sarva guru tumi jagate rahay. You are the most advanced devotee on this planet. Sanatan Goswami gave this title to Haridas Thakur, Jagatera Arya, the most qualified devotee on the planet. This is our Mahajan, Brahmaji. He is very great, but very humble, very tolerant, prideless, and very respectful on always chanting Harinam. Because in Kali Yuga, nothing else works. We saw the verse, Harir Nam, Harir Nam, Harir Nam, Eva Kevalam, Kalau Nasteva Nasteva Nasteva. So like this, we should meditate on the transcendental qualities of Lord Brahmaji, his wonderful qualities, his wonderful teachings as Mahajan, and the ultimate quality of Brahmaji that is very dear to my heart is how he is there to bless us today. Haridas Thakur preached so much. He preached to Jagai and Madai. He preached to Gopal Chakravarti. He preached to Ramchandra Khan. He preached to so many people. He was the preaching partner of Nityananda Prabhu. Nadi Yago Drumme Nityananda Mahajan. As Nityananda Prabhu was, Nitai was preaching. Haridas Thakur was his preaching companion. 15 hours he would chant 192 rounds. Hare Krishna. 5 hours for 64 rounds. And then remaining hours he would be preaching. 8-9 hours he would preach with Nityananda Prabhu. And do Nam Sankirtan with Mahaprabhu at Srivasangan. This was the Dinacharya, the daily routine of Haridas Thakur. Preached a lot. But that preaching remained confined to Bharatvarsha, to the country of India, for 5 centuries. Not 5 years, 15 years, 55 years. For 5 centuries, that preaching remained confined to India. But after 500 years, arose one Acharya. Om Vishnupad Paramhams Parivrajak Acharya Shtottar Shata Shri Shrimad Abhay Charana Arvinda Bhakti Vedanta Swami Maharaj Srila Prabhupada, our beloved founder Acharya. Taking a free passage, not even a proper passenger ticket, not on a cruise ship like we like to go on cruise, cargo ship, free ticket, Srila Prabhupada took and traveled for almost 40 days on the ocean and came to USA. With no help, living with the hippies, living a very, very austere life, away from his beloved Vrindavan Dham, Srila Prabhupada tried to establish Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's movement in the Western world, following the orders of his beloved Guru Maharaj Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur Prabhupada. Our Prabhupada was trying his best, struggling, crying alone in the wilderness of New York City. And somehow with great difficulty, some boys and girls came. And Srila Prabhupada was preaching. Gauravani Pracharina. He was preaching the message of Mahaprabhu. And who is Mahaprabhu? He is the heart throb of Thakur Mahashaya, Haridas Thakur, Lord Brahma. He was preaching Krishna consciousness. A big auditorium was booked and hardly anyone showed up. Only the first row was filled. Some dozen people visitors came and the capacity was several hundred. The devotees were very disappointed. As they were going back to Srila Prabhupada's apartment, they apologized to Srila Prabhupada. Sorry, Prabhupada. Sorry, Swami Maharaj. We booked such an expensive auditorium, but no one showed up. Eh? Did you not see? There was Brahmaji. There was Narad Muni. You see, my dear friends, when Brahmaji and Narad Muni saw, who is Narad Muni? He is Srivas Thakur, Gaura Parshad. Who is Brahmaji? Haridas Thakur, Gaura Parshad. They are seeing that Gauravani Pracharine, Nirvesheja Shunyavadi, Paschatya Deshatarine, history is being written by Srila Prabhupada. Gauravani is spreading in the Paschatya Desh. Never before this planet has seen this incredible historical event. Lord Brahmaji, our Mahajan, and Narad Muni, another Mahajan, 2 Mahajans are there. Invisible to all, but visible to their beloved Srila Prabhupada, ready to bless all of us. I would like to conclude, my dear friends, that Lord Brahmaji, the first Mahajan, is there with us today in Srila Prabhupada's movement to bless and empower of us, only if we are sincere. So Gaur Leela continues, Prabhupada Leela continues, and we are very fortunate to be part of that. So let us understand our good fortune and not waste a single moment. Tivrena bhakti yogena yajeta purusha param. Tivrata se. Let us practice bhakti and make our life successful by pleasing the 12 Mahajans and by pleasing Srila Prabhupada. Jagat Guru Srila Prabhupada ki जय लॉर्ड ब्रह्मा जी की जय निताई गौर प्रेमानंदी हरि हरि थैंक यू वेरी मच
हरे कृष्णा प्रभु थैंक यू सो मच वंस अगेन फॉर द मोस्ट अमेजिंग क्लास आई नो वी आर अ लिटिल बिट कट फॉर टाइम टुडे But I just want to see if there's anyone who would like to ask a question or leave a comment. Then go ahead. Okay, I see two hands raised. Santosh Chaitanya Prabhu, if you're ready, you may go ahead.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Prabhu. Thank you so much for your lecture.
Hare Krishna.
I have a question. What makes a devotee Mahajan? There are so many other good devotees like. We can take an example of Dhruva Maharaj. Why he is not a Mahajan or why Bharat Maharaj is not a Mahajan. So, and this related question is, did Krishna give the devotees this designation or this designation they acquire?
Krishna has given. So Srimad Bhagavatam explains that by Krishna's mercy, these 12 Mahajans, they have understood the confidential nature of Bhagavad Dharma. So it is Krishna's mercy upon them. And as far as why Dhruva Maharaj or Bharat Maharaj are not Mahajans, is because there are many Mahajans actually. And even Srila Prabhupada is a Mahajan in that sense. Srila Prabhupada is also a Mahajan. Is Hanumanji a Mahajan? Yes, because Hanumanji is an expansion of Lord Shiva and Lord Shiva is a Mahajan. So like that, there are many, many Mahajans, but specifically these 12 Mahajans are enumerated. They are mentioned as being specially empowered to teach the principles of Dharma. So the Mahajans are not just practicing, but they are also teaching. Apane acharya keha na kare prachar, prachara kare na keha na kare achar. So they are having achar and they are having prachar also. That is a Mahajan. Preaches. Lord Shiva is preaching to the most difficult people. The bhoot, preet, all the ghosts and goblins, he's preaching. Similarly, Brahmaji also, as Haridas Thakur, he's preaching to the most difficult people. He tried to preach to Jagai Madai, along with Nitai. So Mahajans are specific people, personalities, who have good achar, they have good knowledge, and they are good preachers also. So these are the 12 Mahajans that are specifically mentioned. But again, one Mahajan creates more Mahajans. Just like Srila Prabhupada is a pure devotee, and he created pure devotees. He created pure devotees. Mahajans create more Mahajans. So like that, this is a parampara of Mahajan. All the acharyas are Mahajans. The parampara of Mahajans continues. But these 12 are prominent ones, specially empowered by Krishna. Is that okay, Prabhu?
Yes, Prabhu. Thank you so much.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Thank you so much, Santosh Chaitanya Prabhu, for the wonderful question, and Adhikarara Prabhu for the lovely answer. Prabhu, you have time. We do have some more questions.
I have time, Prabhu, but I know it's late, so we'll keep it very quick and short.
Okay, so there's one more hand raised here. Gayatri Mataji, if you are ready, you may go ahead.
Yes, Hare Krishna. All glories to Srila Prabhupada. I have a question. So today we spoke about Mahajans who know the supreme dharma of how to love the supreme personality of Godhead. But what about the smaller dharmas? When we come to situations when there are two dharmas which contradict each other, how do we know which preference we which dharma should we fulfill? Is there any scale of the like smaller dharmas?
Yes, yes, Gayatri Mataji. So in Srimad Bhagavatam it is said, Savai pumsa paro dharmo yatho bhakti radhokshaje ahaituki apratihata yayatma suprasidati. Savaya pumsam paro dharmo. So there is paro dharmo, which is Bhagavad dharma. Yatho bhakti radhokshaje. Krishna bhakti is a supreme dharma. It is the jaiva dharma. And like we discussed, there are many other sub dharmas, which are lower dharmas, like desh dharma, country dharma, our duty towards the country, kula dharma, our duty responsibilities towards the family, deha dharma, taking care of our body, and so many other things. So whenever there is a conflict between different dharmas, we have to choose the higher dharma. Hare Krishna. And this situation we come across every day. Every day in our life, there will be apparent need to choose between different dharmas. And we make spiritual advancement to the degree we choose Bhagavad Dharma, Jaiva Dharma. For example, Bhishma Dev, he kept silent when Draupadi Devi was being attacked by Dushyasana in the Kuru Sabha. He kept silent because it was the Rajya Dharma. that the king is presiding, Dhritarashtra Maharaj is presiding. Only Dhritarashtra Maharaj has the authority to stop his son, Dushasan. I don't have. So considering that Rajya Dharma, Bhishma Dev kept quiet. But Rajya Dharma is lower dharma. Higher than that is Vaishnava Dharma. A Vaishnavi is being molested. A Vaishnavi is being exploited. That is Vaishnava Dharma. We have to fight. That is the higher dharma. Ladini Mataji. Do you know Ladini Mataji, Srila Prabhupada's disciple? Have you heard of her?
No, I haven't.
Maybe some other time I will tell you this story. Many times there is a conflict between different dharmas. And we make advancement to the degree we choose higher dharma. So we should choose. So Bhishma Deva should have saved, protected Draupadi Devi. That would have been the higher dharma. Our acharyas mentioned like that. That's why Bhishma Deva accepted the punishment of lying on the bed of arrows. Hare Krishna. So therefore, we should always choose Bhagavad Dharma. We should choose Jaiva Dharma, eternal dharma, Krishna Bhakti. And we should slowly, slowly give up the lower dharmas. Is that okay, Gayatri Mataji?
Yes, and where can we learn which dharma is higher and which one is lower?
By Srila Prabhupada's books. Srila Prabhupada's books are teaching us Bhagavad Dharma. Srila Prabhupada teaches us Bhagavad Dharma extensively in his Bhaktivedanta purports. So we should read Srila Prabhupada's books and then we'll understand what is Bhagavad Dharma and how we should choose it over other dharmas, lower dharmas.
Okay, thank you. Thank you for your answer.
You're most welcome, Gayatri Mataji. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Thank you so much, Gayatri Mataji, for the every question, and Prabhu for the wonderful answer. So, I'd like to thank Adigarada Prabhu for once again giving us such an amazing class. Prabhu, the highlight for me during the class was where you were mentioning the verses from Navadip Mahatmya, Lord Brahma and Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Those were very, very sweet, and they really, really touched my heart, and such a wonderful, wonderful highlight for me during the class, Prabhu. Also, I'd like to mention, Prabhu, the way you read and recite these verses, sing these verses so melodiously, it's very, very pleasing to the ears, Prabhu. You sound like a Gandharva, Prabhu. It is very, very wonderful to hear. You can actually hear the enthusiasm and the love and the bhakti coming from your voice, and that projects onto the audience. For me personally, I can feel that coming from you, Prabhu. So thank you so much once again for your wonderful, wonderful class and for your association. And we definitely look forward to hearing from you again soon, Prabhu. Thank you so much.
Hare Krishna. Jai Shila Prabhupada.
Jai Prabhupada.